हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, मायसेल्फ असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर नम्रता खिलोचिया, राफेल बीबीए कॉलेज, वापी. विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू द सब्जेक्ट एनपीएम, दैट इज न्यू प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट, टीवाईबीबीए, फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर, वी आर मूविंग फॉरवर्ड विथ यूनिट नंबर टू, दैट इज प्रोजेक्ट अप्रेजल. इन द लास्ट वन सेशन वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विथ द थर्ड स्टेप of project appraisal, that is technical analysis. Now, technical aspect can be critically analyzed in four major areas, that is location, site, size of the plant, which is also called as scale of operation, and technical feasibility. We had also discussed eight major factors affecting to the location. So let's continue with factors affecting location. Moving with the ninth one factor, that is strategic consideration. Here, strategic consideration factor also affecting to the selection of location or geographical area. It influence to the industry. It is not likely that major industries will be located in strategically sensitive areas, even if all the economic factors favor such a location. Especially in the case of strategic industries, special care is taken to be assured that the location chosen is not easily accessible to the military forces of other countries. For example, while establishing the defense industries, definitely here we need to take care that the location will be strategic location and will not affect to the military area of other countries. Tenth one factor which affecting to the location selection, that is taxes and fees. Variations in taxes, fees and charge may also influence industrial location selection. These taxes and charges may vary from state to other state. 11th one, incentives and disincentives. There are also certain incentives, or you can say that motivational strategies, and disincentives, that means non-motivational tools. For that, government can apply to the industrial area so that the new entrepreneur will distract from the particular location selection. For instance, in India, the union and state government offers a number of fiscal, monetary and physical incentives for industries in the notified backward regions. As for example, here if we take example of incentives, that means those location where the government, that is union government as well as state government, offers different incentives or motivational factors like easy licensing procedures and registration procedures as well as cheaper land cost, etc. If we talk regarding the Anjar area, after the natural calamity, that is earthquake, now government offering different subsidies to establish and rejuvenate this area for new industrial development. Certain disincentives are also offered by government, like higher taxes may discourage industries in certain region to control the industrial development in particular territory. Government may even ban new industrial units in congested or particular specific areas where large urban areas or developed region are nearby. Moving forward with the 12th one factor, that is site and services. Some industries require a large area of land which may not be available in a locally area where all other factors are favorable. Availability of the required type and quantity of land at a reasonable price is thus the most important factor. with a view to developing industries in certain region or territory, government has providing developed site and necessary facilities and services like road development and traffic signals near to the industrial area, etc. Certain such location like Hosur in Tamil Nadu have been very successful in learning or developing the industries. Same thing happened with the Bhuj and Anjar after earthquake. Government offers different subsidies even for construction of the building of factory. So now this area is much developed than earlier. Similarly, industrial estates have been established in different parts of the country to encourage the development of industries. Moving with the 13th one factor, that is socio-economic and political factors. See students, all these three factors also affecting to the selection of location, especially in respect of the location of public sector units. Some large-scale public sector units are located in backward region. On such consideration, so that they can enjoy different motivational or incentive tools like subsidies, cheaper land cost, etc. For example, to enhance the employment opportunity, government give permission to the Tata near to the Sanand plant for production of the nano car. The 14th one, that is miscellaneous or other factors. There are also a number of other factors that may influence industrial location. The attitude of local community, proximity of the complementary industries, prospect of the development of region, service facilities required by the industry, recreational and social facilities, nearness to the important sectors like hospitals, metropolitan centers, personal factors, etc. may affect to the selection of location. Now, the second factor under technical analysis, that is site. There are a number of important factors to be considered in the selection of a particular site. Again, I am repeating students, site is a particular piece of land in that particular location. This include the load-bearing capacity of the site, towards the flood and earthquake hazards, access to the transportation facilities, facilities for water supply and effluent discharge. Also, it includes ecological factors, etc. The nature of the industry has a bearing on the site selection. For example, some industries like paper mill industry need abundant use of supply of water. For some industries, effluent discharge is a major problem. Environmental pollution is also a serious problem that certain industries have to confront with. All these factors influence the selection of site. Moving with the third one factor affecting to the technical appraisal, that is size of the plant or scale of the operation. The size of the plant or scale of the operation is an important factor that determines the economic and financial feasibility or suitability of project. In many industries, there are certain technological plant capacities which are economical if the size is suboptimal or less utilized, there will be diseconomies of scale. The fourth one factor under technical analysis, that is technical feasibility. Appraisal of the technical aspect of a project involves scrutiny of such aspect of the project like manufacturing project or technology selected, technical collaboration arrangement, if any, with the company, capacity or size of the project and the scale of operation, location of the project, availability of physical and social infrastructural facilities, availability of the different inputs like raw material and all other utilities facilities, selection of the plant, machinery and equipment together with the background, competency and capacity of machinery, equipment, supplies. Plant layout and factory building, technical engineering services, project design and network analysis are different considerations need to be critically analyzed under technical feasibility. The technical feasibility study should consider the adequacy and suitability of the plant, the equipment and their specification, plant layout, balancing of the different sections of the plant, proposed arrangement for the procurement of plant and equipment, reputation of the machinery, suppliers, etc. The feasibility study should also consider the technology required for a particular project, evaluate technological alternatives and select the most appropriate technology in terms of optimum combination of project components. So, these are the major four consideration or sub-factors we need to take care while analyzing the viability of technical aspect. Thank you, students.